So, as you guys saw, my car got destroyed by a driver who wasn't paying attention, I guess. So I'll give you the story. I know it's been a couple of weeks since I've posted a video. To be honest, it was very difficult to get a video out because I didn't. I was kind of upset at the whole situation, as far as, you know, my car getting hit and how much damage it was, and you know, it just hurt. It hurt me to look at it. You know, it was very unfortunate, but such is life sometimes, you know. Sometimes things don't never go the way you plan them, and accidents happen. I think I'm still also very fortunate that the gentleman who rammed my car, pretty much, well, you know what, let me start back from the beginning. So what happened, this is how it all happened. I was working, actually, inside the house, you know, minding my business or whatever, and then I heard a loud thud that I couldn't quite explain, but I ignored it because I just figured it was just something that fell in the basement. I don't know. It just didn't seem like nothing broke or whatever, so I just kind of ignored it. But I got a knock at the door, and it was this gentleman who said, "Oh, I'm so sorry, I hit your car, and you know, sorry about that," whatever. So I'm like, you know, the first thing that's going through my head is, you know, please don't let it be the 86. And you know, which kind of sucks because I have both of these cars, and obviously, you know, in my situation, I'm trying to trade or sell this car, and you know, do something else. So I was like, damn, if this thing gets hit again, you know, in less than what, less than 90 days, it's just, man, it's horrible luck. But you know, my worst nightmare came true, and it was my GR86, and it was pretty bad, as you can see in the video I put in there. But you know what, I didn't know what to think at first when, you know, I was looking at the damage, but I had to, you know, bring myself back into reality and remember that, you know, there was a person in there. And mind you, he neglected maintenance. So for those of you car owners out there that think they can get away with, you know, ignoring typical maintenance on your car, I think if you are a car person, which most of you are who watch this channel, you already know just as well as I do that maintenance is very important. For example, today I was actually going to hold off on the oil change because I was hoping maybe I would get some good news about my car and getting it back this week, but I doubt that I'm going to see it within the next week and a half. So I said, well, I do have the Miata, and it was up for an oil change in a few hundred miles. So, you know, I'm really big on making sure the car is well maintained. And for me, it was more or less, you know what, let me just get the maintenance done out the way now. Even though I'm going to get rid of the car, I'd rather give somebody something and not risk, you know, catastrophic failure like the engine blowing up or something like that. I'd rather give them something that's they can just get in and drive. And I also put new front brakes on there as well. So, you know, whoever gets this car next is definitely going to get hooked up. But I kind of went off on a tangent there. So, you know, maintenance is very important. And what happened with this gentleman, by the way, he was in a 2014 Kia Soul, the little gerbil car. Didn't look that great. Obviously, it was probably a hand-me-down or something that he bought really, really cheap. The right tire was on his passenger side, had bursted and, you know, bursted off his car. And then he had lost control coming up on our neighborhood where we where I'm staying at, and obviously losing control and turning to the right where my car was parked right on the side of the street. Mind you, it's a pretty decent sized street, so you would really be have to be going at speed to hit my car the way it looked. So my guess is he was going kind of fast, well, too fast, and wasn't paying attention, and he ended up losing control of the car once the tire popped off. And mind you, that tire was, I should have taken a picture of it. I don't know if I did or not, but that tire was pretty bald. And they tried to put a spare on while the authorities were assessing the accident and kind of getting everybody's insurance and me reporting the accident and whatnot. They were trying to put a spare tire on, and from what I was told, because I wasn't really paying attention to it, I was just worried about my car, to be honest, because I actually had to go out of town that day. So there goes that, you know, I couldn't do that. So apparently his front axle was broken. And I'm like, how did that happen? Like, that's crazy, because they tried to just put on a spare so he can just drive home or whatever. But, you know, his front axle was broken. And I'm just like, dude, this is ridiculous. But it goes to show you that never neglect your maintenance, everyone. Just don't neglect the maintenance. And take care of your cars when you have them. And, you know, things like that wouldn't happen. He could have avoided that. And obviously, if you're in a neighborhood, 15 miles per hour or less is usually the rule of thumb for these things. And he had to have been going at least 35 to from the weight of my car. And he lost control from the way that happened. He had to have been going faster than 15 miles an hour. But I digress. The good thing about it is, he was covered, his insurance and everything. And my car is currently gonna get fixed. They haven't told me it was totaled yet, but they're really taking their time on doing this estimate, which makes me kind of nervous. But I think ultimately the reason why I am nervous about it and bugging them so much is because it's my damn car, you know. I want my car back, and you know, I just want to see it back the way I had it, you know, initially. And I also told the collision company to, when they do begin to order parts, if they can send me a copy of the manifest, so that I can see if they ordered, you know, genuine OEM Toyota parts rather than getting something, you know, that is from another car or whatever the case is. I don't know if companies do that or not, but I just want to make sure that I'm not being, you know, bamboozled or whatever. So I'm definitely going to look at that and make sure that these guys aren't doing, you know, some witchcraft over there and just putting pieces together like a puzzle and for parts that don't belong and everything like that. So, you know, like I said, good thing is that his insurance is covering everything. They did offer me a rental car, but I have a Miata, so I didn't necessarily need it. I wanted to take it because, again, I'm adding more miles on the car, which can lower the value down a bit, but it's around the summer, so I think I could still get a good amount of money for this car. So I don't think I'm in too big of a deficit here, but after about this week, I probably won't be driving it much anyway until it's gone. So I think ultimately, you know, it'll be okay. I'm trying to be optimistic about it. It's still very, very bizarre knowing that my car just got destroyed. When I did call the collision company today, they did tell me the door is going to have to be replaced. And they said that they have a brand new one, a brand new Subaru door coming in. So, I mean, again, I'm a little optimistic about it, and I hope that whatever they have is OEM. you know, it fits and it's not, you know, the alignment's not off and stuff like that. So, you know, but again, when I first got the initial, you know, news of the accident, when he told me, I was flabbergasted because I'm like, dang it, dude. Like, I can't seem to catch a break. Like, I'm doing, you know, this car, the Miata had gotten nudged a bit a few months ago. And then now this, and it's like, dude, like, what the heck is going on? But, you know, thankfully, again, I wasn't in the car. And to be honest, thankfully that he came out of that okay. He didn't seem hurt. He was very apologetic about it. Again, initially, I was pretty upset about it. I didn't yell at him or anything. I did keep my composure. But it's somebody's life, and I never wish death on anyone or for them to get badly injured. So honestly, I did step back, and I ultimately, you know, thanked, you know, the heavens that he didn't kill himself, you know, hitting my car and everything like that. So now I'm hoping that he would learn the lesson that, you know, car maintenance is very important. Keeping your car well maintained is key, because you can kill yourself, like in that instance, or kill someone else. So I think that's what I mainly got from that whole situation, is that maintenance, car maintenance, and paying attention to the warning signs, and you know, and the cost of having a good person like him that could have easily have not, you know, well, he couldn't have taken off, but there have been plenty of hit and runs that I'm sure you guys have witnessed or been a part of that happens. And I'm just thankful that the guy was fully covered. State Farm is doing their job to you know, fix the car up and everything. So, you know, at the end of the day, I'm pretty lucky that the right person hit me, I guess, or hit my car. So I think that's all I got. That's the story. That's what happened to the 86. She will be back in better than ever, and I think we will come back from this stronger. And like I said, for those of you guys who, you know, have neglected maintenance before, let this story be a lesson to you that maintenance is the number one priority. Before you do any mods, make sure your car is well maintained first. Mods don't mean anything if your car doesn't run or run properly. And with that being said, fellas, that's it. I'll see you guys in another video, hopefully in about a week or so. And hopefully at that point, my GR86 is back.